Hello, this is Case Medlin with Range and Pasture. It's the second week of January. We're back out in a Bermuda grass field scouting sandbur plants. Our main objective today is to determine if this population of sandbur that we're in is a perennial species or it's an annual species. Now is an excellent time to be making that decision. Why do we need to do this? That affects your herbicide program that you're going to use to control your sandbur. But one thing that we need to do, don't just walk across the field and inspect them from the soles of your feet. You need to be getting into that field, extracting some of those plants, because what you see underneath those plants or the underneath side of those plants will be the telltale sign whether or not you're fighting an annual population of sandbur or perennial population of sandbur. So as you're looking at them from the soles of your feet, basically what you're gonna see is a lot of browned out material. You're not gonna see very much green at this time. However, when you extract those plants and actually turn them over, that's when you're gonna start seeing the green stems, green leaves, and things like that, that are, basically that area is protected a little bit more from the environmental conditions. The other thing you can do is split those crowns open, use a knife or some type of cutter, and split those crowns open. If you have any moisture down in there, or you see any green material down in the depths of that crown on these plants, then that's probably going to be a perennial plant as well. If everything breaks apart, crumbles apart, you see no moisture, that's probably an annual species of sandbur. So makes life a little bit easier, at least for you, if it is an annual species. So with these perennial plants, we're going to have to treat those with a post-emergence herbicide. Now is not the time. There's not enough green plant material to take up that herbicide and actually help control these plants. We're going to have to wait till perhaps after the first hay harvest, when we remove all the forage that's out here. Those perennial plants typically prostrate out on the ground, leaving enough leaf material at that time to control them with a post-emergence herbicide. So now's not the time to control these perennial plants. We'll come back to that at a later time. Regardless if you're fighting an annual species of sandbur or a perennial species of sandbur, Rezilon is going to be the foundation. We've got to control those plants coming from seed. We need to have that Rezilon on the first application sometime between now, the middle of January, up through the middle of February, so before Valentine's Day. Get 3 ounces of Rezilon put on. That needs to be followed in with rainfall or irrigation if you have it, to activate that so the Rezilon is sitting there waiting for those sandbur seed to start germinating. So now is the time. You're not too early. That's when it needs to be done. As my good friend Dr. Jason Belcher says over in Alabama, early is on time with Rezilon, so get it done. Happy spraying. Get the Rezilon put out. Let's get ahead of these sandburs. Thank you for your business. Take care and have a good day.